Hey everyone, Cole here. You guys got to take a listen to the podcast I was on recently with my friend Advaith. We talked about sports, business, and all sorts of fun stuff, and I really support what he is doing. Also, give me a follow on Twitter. I'm going to start tweeting a bunch of stuff and giving all sorts of takes on there, so go hit me up there. All right, let's talk about the Hurricanes. For the longest time, the Carolina Hurricanes were the biggest joke in the NHL. Despite making two Stanley Cups in their franchise's history and winning one of them, there was talk recently about possibly relocating this team because fan attendance was one of the worst in the league. From 2014 through last year, they were a bottom three team in the league in attendance. They would draw around 11,500 fans when they could hold up to 18,500. The Hurricanes missed the playoffs for 9 straight seasons before the past year, which was the longest streak in the NHL. They play in Raleigh, North Carolina, and play at PNC Arena, which is right on North Carolina State's campus. So basically, they are an NHL team playing in a college town. Now that used to be a bad thing to say, but now, it's kind of becoming the trendy thing. Attendance woes has been because of this team's poor performance, lack of a superstar player, and so many coaching changes. But this past season was what sparked everything for them, and they are off to a great start this season. So let's look back at how this franchise started out, and how their current roster was built. But before the video begins, I have a great announcement to make. I have partnered with Ranking Ball to promote their website. If you are a sports fan like me, you can enjoy all the leagues like basketball, hockey, football, baseball, European soccer, and even esports, and their team is working hard to add more leagues. Follow every action in real time with 3D rendered animations, where you don't have to read the action, but you can see the plays unfold with their stunning graphics as if you were actually at the game. It's free to sign up and requires no deposit, and is the new style of fantasy sports. They also have a mobile app called Ranking Ball, which requires no real cash deposit and is fun to play. Both the links for the website and the app are in the description of this video. The website is available to play in these 28 states. It requires real cash deposits and includes rewards. And sign up now and get a $5 bonus and a pick ticket voucher daily. And join now for their 1 million event during the NFL season. The app is free and for fun, but the website has actual money involved. So what are you waiting for? Go check them out because both the links are in the description of this video. The Carolina Hurricanes, well, were not always the Carolina Hurricanes. They used to be the Hartford Whalers, who were in the NHL from 1979 through 1997. The Whalers had bad marketability in a market that was dominated by the Boston Bruins, so they moved south and gave the Carolinas a hockey team. The Hurricanes didn't make the playoffs in their first season, but in their second season, the Hurricanes finished first in the division, and made the playoffs but lost to the Bruins in the first round. 2000 they missed the playoffs, and 2001 they lost in the first round to the Devils. But the 2002 season they won their division, beat the Devils, Canadiens, and Maple Leafs to make the Stanley Cup Final before losing to the Red Wings in 5 games. The next two seasons they would miss the playoffs, and then there was the lockout season. But 2006 is that magic moment for the Hurricanes in their history, and gives everyone hope that you can win a Stanley Cup in a small market, and you can do it in the Carolinas. They were a huge surprise this season, and finished 55-22-8, and had 112 points, which was their best record in franchise history for both Carolina and Hartford. They were the fourth best team in the league and won their division title. Their coach was Peter Laviolette, who was there from 2003-2009, and later in his career would coach the Flyers and Predators to the Stanley Cup Final. The constructor of the team was Jim Rutherford, who would be the team's GM from 1994 through 2014. And this team was led by Captain Rod Brindamour, who is the current head coach of the Hurricanes, and a big reason why I think they've been so successful. 21-year-old center Eric Staal scored 100 points this season and had 45 goals. And 24-year-old right winger Justin Williams was their other huge playmaker. And finally, in the Stanley Cup Final, they beat the Edmonton Oilers in a 7-game series of two unlikely teams. Cam Ward won the Conn Smythe, and the Hurricanes' future looked bright considering they had their goalie of the future and their franchise centerpiece in Eric Staal. But after this Stanley Cup championship, the Hurricanes only made the playoffs once until last year. The season they did make it was the 2008-2009 season, and they did end up getting all the way to the Eastern Conference Finals, but after that, every season has been filled with disappointment and a lack of hope. They have had some promising young players, and some seasons where they looked like they could be a young, surprising team, but that never happened. But the New Age Hurricanes were changed in 2018 thanks to new ownership, and everything going forward has been extremely promising. It is a wild roller coaster to how we got here. But let's start out with the guys in the front office. Well, first, this team was owned by Peter Karmenos, who purchased the Whalers in 1994 with his group for $47.5 million. And then he moved the Whalers to Carolina because of a lack of fan support in Hartford. So in Raleigh, North Carolina, the Hurricanes were owned by him all the way up until January 11th of 2018. when he sold his controlling interest in the Hurricanes to Tom Dundon, while he would still retain minority interest. Dundon came in and bought his 61% stake for $420 million. But Dundon is a different breed when it comes to owners. He is 47 years old, making him one of the youngest owners in North American professional sports, if I'm not mistaken. Gonna have to have someone fact check that for me. But Tom is a smart guy, and he's kinda cheap, so he's done a good job building smart with his new age tactics, and has had his team extremely marketable by appealing to younger fans and really pissing off older fans. The Hurricanes have been trying to find new ways to get their fans more involved, and last season they started doing celebrations after each home win on the ice called the Storm Surge. And these celebrations were really creative, and it helped get fans extremely excited after games, and made them feel more connected to the team. And it sparked a lot of debate in the media whether this was acceptable or not, and Dundon was a huge supporter of it. And then Don Cherry called this team a bunch of jerks, and they rode that mantra until the end of the season, and I will give them this. They might have gotten a little over their heads more than I would have liked, but they've backed it up on the ice. And they are doing it again this year, and this train is not stopping anytime soon. The fans were loving it, and they started showing up again, and they were selling more tickets than they had seats. Merchandise was flying off the racks, and the Carolina Hurricanes were back. The constructor of this team was general manager Donnie Waddell, who joined the Hurricanes after Jim Rutherford left in 2014, and Waddell became the team's president. The team's former GM was Ron Francis, but Francis had his contract terminated in April of 2018, and is now going to be the GM of the new Seattle NHL franchise. Waddell became GM in May of 2018, and also in May, Hurricanes promoted Rod Brindamour to head coach, having been an assistant coach from 2011 through 2018. With the organization working under coaches Kirk Miller and Bill Peters. So Dundon came in and put his guys in charge and told the others to get out, and while it didn't seem as smooth as it typically would look, the Hurricanes have not been the same ever since this has happened, and that was 100% for the best. When Coach Brindamour took over, everything changed for this team. Their coach is about as serious as they come, and this dude is extremely intense. Also, this guy is always in the gym room, so if you're not careful, your own coach could be outworking you, and this has probably changed the culture of the team and kept everyone on their toes. Brindamour was such a relatable guy for the players to buy into, and it made him such a perfect candidate for the job, and the Hurricanes have played really hard under him for most of the season. The Hurricanes play under their structure, play extremely hard, and stick to their game plan, and play like a team for all lines. But in all honesty, before the puck dropped in October of last year, fans around the NHL were trying to understand what exactly the Hurricanes were doing. There was constant talk about the team trading some of their top players, and they ended up doing that by trading Jeff Skinner to the Buffalo Sabres in exchange for a second, third, and sixth round pick and a prospect who would later be traded to the Panthers. Then they traded their promising young defenseman Noah Hanifin and winger Elias Lindholm to Calgary for defenseman Dougie Hamilton and Michael Ferland. Hamilton has been great in Carolina and is a fan favorite, and he has the trust of the coaching staff on defense, and he has honestly been the best Hurricane and plays the most minutes. So let's talk about some of the Hurricanes' best players over the past two seasons. First, we have Justin Williams, who was brought back to the Hurricanes in 2017 after spending time with the Kings and Capitals, and he would be the team's captain for the 2018 season, but he is taking a break from the NHL currently. Sebastian Aho is the team's leading goal scorer. Aho was drafted in the second round of the 2015 draft, and each season he's been in the league, he has gotten better, and has gone from 49 to 65 to 83 points in his first three seasons. And thankfully they matched the Montreal Canadiens' offer sheet on him for 5 years, $42 million, because he is their playmaker and their franchise centerpiece. During the 2018 draft lottery, the Hurricanes jumped from the number 11 spot to the number 2 spot, and were able to draft Russian winger Andrei Svechnikov. Andrei started playing really well right away for the Hurricanes, and has played a big part of moving the puck around and leads the team in assist, and is one of the brightest young players on their roster. Then we have Teuvo Teravainen, who was acquired from the Blackhawks in 2016, and was second on their team in points last season. Teuvo is somebody that is young and full of potential. His numbers are very comparable to Aho's, and has gotten better every single season for the Canes, and is their other young superstar that helps their offense. Now for some veterans. Their new team captain, Jordan Staal, played for the Penguins from 2006 to 2012 and won a cup there. And then he was traded to the Hurricanes, has been their co-captain before, but was named team captain for this season. Next up is Nino Niederreiter. Nino played for the Islanders and Wild before being traded to the Hurricanes in January in exchange for Victor Rask. And when Nino got there, he has played unreal hockey and has revived his career in Carolina. Eric Halla was traded to the Hurricanes this year after being a key part in the transformation of the Golden Knights, and Halla currently leads the team in goals. Then we have some of their other core defensemen, Jacob Slavin, Joel Edmondson, and Jake Gardner. Edmondson they recently acquired from the St. Louis Blues in exchange for defenseman Justin Falk, which worked out because they got a proven defenseman from a championship team for a guy they tried moving on from. Jacob Slavin has been one of the most underrated defensemen in the NHL, and is an absolutely fantastic defender. and Jake Gardner comes over from Toronto on a four-year deal, which put them over the cap for the first time in the salary cap era, but he was the best defenseman on the market, and now they have the deepest blue line in the National Hockey League. Now for their goalies, Peter Mrazek and James Reimer are their starter and backup, but Mrazek has done great for them despite being a backup-level goalie, and has come in as the starter and done great for them. And even Reimer has done well, and they split time early equally this season, and if there's anything that makes me worried about Carolina, it's the goalie play, but they have been able to rotate well, so if one doesn't play well, the other can come in and play. Now let's talk about how things have played out during the 2018 season and beyond. The Hurricanes were not projected to be a playoff team last year, and it was up in the air what exactly they would be. Through the end of December, the Hurricanes were shooting an NHL worst 5.5% during 5-on-5 play, so they weren't in the playoff picture at a 16-17-5 record, despite playing good defense. But after January 1st, they shot 8.8% on 5-on-5 and went 30-12-2. So it took some time to get the goals they needed to keep up in the NHL under their new coach, but when they did, things started to play out very well and their defense became elite. On April 4th, they beat the Devils to clinch a playoff spot for the first time in 9 years. They finished the season as the first wildcard team in the East, but they had a matchup of death with the reigning Stanley Cup champion Washington Capitals. In the playoffs, they went on to actually beat the Washington Capitals in a 7-game series, and Game 7 went to double overtime, and the Hurricanes won 4-3 in double overtime. The next round, they faced another team that was very similar to them in the New York Islanders, and they went on to sweep them in the second round. However, in the Eastern Conference Finals, they were ultimately swept by the Boston Bruins in 4 games. But the story doesn't end there, because the Carolina Hurricanes are off to a hot start and are one of the best teams in the NHL so far with a 9-3-1 record. There's nothing better than a good story, and the Hurricanes have been exactly that for the past year now, and it's so refreshing to see a competitive team in Carolina. They have a lot of solid young players, so this success should last, and they should be good for most of the future. I always think the small market teams can be the most dangerous if it's a perfect storm, no pun intended. They don't have as much pressure and can play their game for their fans specifically and not have to represent more like the original six teams or Canadian-based team. The 2018-2019 season completely saved this franchise, and it's not something you typically will see in professional sports. But the Hurricanes have done everything different than what people would project, and they have been one of the best teams in hockey over the past 2 seasons. So let me know what you think about the Carolina Hurricanes, and I hope some Hurricanes fans got to see this video, and I really hope you enjoyed. Thank you for watching, everyone. Don't forget to go check out GoRankingBall.com and their app Ranking Ball, and leave a like and subscribe. Peace out, everyone.